ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, my name is the Ripper Danny B, and welcome to CWR Horizon, coming to you tonight from Fresno, California. Talk about making you wait, huh? Ladies and gentlemen, your opening contest this evening is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Osaka, Japan, she is the CWR Women's World Champion, the Empress of Tomorrow, Asuka! It's still odd to me to see that belt around the waist of another woman. But legitimately though, for 267 days, that belt sat around the waist of the former champion, Legend Jesse, but Asuka carries it with pride. Can't ask for a better champion than the Empress of Tomorrow. The rivalry between those two has certainly gotten heated. It's gotten personal. Originally it was about competition, it was about proving who's better, but things have changed in recent weeks, but that's not about tonight. Tonight, Asuka is here for one-on-one competition. She wants to work out a little bit of those spider webs, I guess, cobwebs, after that attack from Legend Jesse a couple of weeks ago. And ladies and gentlemen, let's introduce ourselves to the victim. Our opponent this evening from Columbus, Ohio, Dana Brooke. Brooke looking to get back some of the momentum she's lost in recent weeks with non-appearances. Dana Brooke, of course, actually managed to qualify for the Battleground Gauntlet back in November. But as time has rolled on, Dana Brooke has not really been in the question. She's not really been in the picture. Dana Brooke tonight looks to get back into this. And look at Asuka though, she's not winning for the bell, look at that! Asuka is not in a good mood. The champion is not in a good mood tonight. And Asuka, well, I was joking when I said, let's introduce ourselves to the victim. Turns out, I couldn't have been more correct. Look at this from Asuka now, just going after Dana. Slides under there. Look at that knee, just driven into the chest of Dana Brooke. Brooke trying to get back to her feet, but Asuka is just there stalking her, but Dana Brooke using her power advantage over Asuka there and able to dump the Women's World Champion. And what a night this could be for Dana Brooke. I say this every time the champion is in the ring because I mean it. It means something. If you can pin a champion, it really does mean something here in CWR. It's not just a throwaway like you see in other companies, like, oh look, so-and-so got a shock pinfall over the world champion. I wonder if they will ever get a title shot. It doesn't work that way here in CWR. You pick up a win over a champion, you certainly put yourself in line. You put yourself in the top five contenders immediately. If you aren't already in there, and if you are in there, you are usually the one who gets the next shot. It's as simple as that. Right now, this is a 1-4 matchup, so these women really do need to get back into this ring if they want to win by pinfall or submission. Obviously, you know, you can win by count out. It doesn't quite work the same. But quite frankly, I don't think Asuka cares about winning tonight. Look at that. Asuka has just dumped Dana Brooke into the front row of the crowd. Dana jumps back over, just crashes back over that barricade. It's the sheer force that Asuka just whacked Dana Brooke, but Brooke trying to fight back, but the Empress of Tomorrow is having none of it. Look at that boot. But Dana, I've got to give her credit here. I mean, Dana Brooke has shocked a few people over the past number of months. Like I say, she's been out of action for a little while. A few non-appearances on shows, but she's definitely made a mark. But speaking of making a mark, did you see that body splash whereas most people would connect sideways, deliver all the impact to the gut, try and win the opponent. That's not Asuka's style. She went vertically on Dana, driving the knee into the skull as she went down. I think Dana might have wanted to take this week off after she's done with this match. Look at that, another knee right to the top of the skull from Asuka. And did you see the height she got on that jump before she came crashing down with all of her weight right into the skull, right into the cranium of Dana Brooke? Dana keeps trying to fight back, but Asuka has an answer for everything. And into the corner goes the Total Diva. Guess you could call her the full package now. Probably not something you want to do. Here's the cover from Dana Brooke. Asuka kicks out at one. Total package. Yeah, I think that one's already been done as well, isn't it? Anyway, the Empress of Tomorrow now on the receiving end of a few strikes from Dana Brooke. Dana trying to turn the game around. Goes for that splash, but Asuka, did you just see the speed of the champion and now the confidence building within Asuka? She is certainly a confident woman, and why wouldn't you be considering the run she's had in recent weeks? Here comes Asuka now, that hip smash, there it is, right across the face of Dana Brooke, but Asuka isn't done now. The only question is, which move is she going to finish this with? She goes for the strikes, the Empress combination. Look at that, just three, and that roundhouse, Dana Brooke out cold. Just look at it, just right around the side of the temple. And the thing that really makes that move hurt is you see Asuka follow through with that foot. It's not like she just clobbers them. The power that she throws to send that foot through. Dana kicked out. I've just written this match off. I'm blubbering about the effectiveness of driving your foot through a move, and Dana kicks out. How on earth does that happen? Not only does she kick out, she's taking control of the matchup again. The entire complexion of this matchup has just changed. Asuka hit Dana Brooke with the best move she has, and Dana kicked out. Asuka, though, not giving in. Just see that. The hip smash once again goes for a drop kick that time, but Dana Brooke this time. But once again, Asuka turns it around. I was almost starting to feel like this could be the night of the ascension of Dana, but no, Asuka just has a number every step of the way. Dana showing resiliency. Credit where credit is due. Wow! That hurt. Look at that, right to the stomach again, and Asuka, for the second time in this matchup, charges the ropes. Here comes that hip driver, right through the face of Dana Brooke. And this, and Asuka is done playing, wraps the arm, brings her down into the middle of the ring. The Asuka lock is in. Dana Brooke, you can see, fighting, but just like everyone else, Dana gives in. Let's take a look back. Some of the moments of this matchup. You see here, Asuka, just that, those strikes are just so deadly. This is the first time she went for that hip smash, drives it through. I mean, it didn't hit as well as the second one did, I'll give her that. But with that kick, I thought Dana was out cold. I said Dana's out cold. I honestly believed it. But somehow, I mean, let's just watch this. How close was it? No, there was time to spare. Asuka, to her credit, didn't get flushed. Pulled it right back, and in the end, the Asuka lock, as it does with everyone else, as it did with the longest reigning champion in CWR history, gets the better of Dana Brooke. Dana taps out, and Asuka, the champion, rolling one more time. And Asuka, just look at the confidence she walks around that ring with. And can you blame her? I can't. She is on top of the world right now. She is not only the most dominant and dangerous competitor in the female division here on Asylum, I don't even know where I am anymore, on Horizon, but she could easily be the most dominant champion in CWR today. And now Asuka has a microphone in hand. What has Asuka got to say following that contest? Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Asuka has made her point clear. The Empress of Tomorrow. There you have it, right there. At Night of Champions, the rematch of all rematches. Legend Jezzy versus Asuka for the Women's World Championship. As always, we've got to move on to our next contest this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is a tag team match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by the CWR Women's Tag Team Champions, Natalya and Tamina, representing the new legacy, the Triple S Champion Carmella, and the Patriot Champion Charlotte. Rare you see all four members of the new legacy out here together, although Tamina kind of hiding away from camera shot a little bit there, but she's out here, believe me. Yeah, not very often at all you see all four members together, but there's a lot of gold on that team right now. A lot of gold. And of course, last week we found out that Carmella will be defending her belt at Night of Champions against Becky Lynch and Sasha Banks. And speaking of the four horsewomen, introducing their opponents first from San Jose, California, it's Bayley. Bayley looking for a momentum booster after taking a loss to Sasha Banks at Payback a few weeks back now. Bayley back in action this evening. I mean, just like pretty much every other female on the roster, Bayley has had her issues with the new legacy. But this isn't about that tonight. Bayley just looking for a momentum builder, whereas the new legacy looking to continue to assert their dominance, holding almost all of the championships here on the brand. And Bayley's tag team partner this evening from San Mateo, California, she is the Dark Angel, Claudia Thorne. Claudia all over CWR these days, dominating on both Dynasty and Horizon. Of course, one of the very few stars to compete on two brands. Tonight, she returns to Horizon. She looks to get herself right back in title contention and a win tonight over no matter what. No matter who she pins, if she was to win this matchup, Claudia would be looking towards another title picture very, very soon, of course. She was defeated by Legend Jezzy in the first show back for Horizon for the Women's World Championship, an opportunity she won back in Exodus. But it isn't about that this evening. It's about tag team competition, and we have it here right now as Charlotte is going to start this thing off against Bayley. See Tamina there now on the outside. All four members in the new legacy out here. Charlotte, the one in the ring, going against Bayley, and straight away using Charlotte. Yep, definitely that one. Charlotte using her power advantage over Bayley, but Bayley sidesteps and tries to get right back in this competition. There's a lot on the line tonight for everyone involved in this matchup. I mean, Carmella, we already know she has a match. She has a match at Night of Champions, the Triple Threat contest. We know that. Charlotte, however, the picture isn't quite so clear. I mean, Emma is going to be looking for her rematch. But Nia Jax has pinned Charlotte twice in the last 3 or 4 weeks. Not to mention the fact Emma is kind of embroiled in her own personal feud with old enemy Jaminal. So, I mean, this is going to be a very interesting week or two when it comes to Charlotte before Night of Champions, but right now Claudia Thorne inside the ring. And you know the complexion of this entire match will change with Thorne in there. From, two technical wrestlers in Bayley and Charlotte to a rather scrappy brawler style in Carmella. You've got that kind of move there from Claudia Thorne, that top rope springboard moonsault. But Charlotte, not letting that damage get to her, comes right back with a Russian leg sweep. And this is an important matchup for Bayley and for Claudia, who are, you know, really both trying to get right back on their game right now. Carmella, as I said, scrappy brawler, a little bit brazen in her attacks there, ended up taking out Charlotte as well as Claudia. And now Thorne makes the tag back to Bayley. The new legacy, should I say. I'm losing it, people. Look at that move there from Bayley and Thorne. That was an interesting combinational move. You can see Claudia Thorne there looked to be setting up to hit Carmella with something, and Carmella wasn't having any of it. And look at Carmella now. She's all over the place. The big night for Carmella. She sat back last week and watched as Naomi and Sasha fought for the right to face her. And tonight she's out here to prove something. I'm quite surprised not to see either Sasha or Becky out here. Maybe they're just watching this matchup from the back, just trying to watch for any weaknesses in Carmella's game. Because quite frankly, I mean, I know all of the new legacy are holding championships right now. But it has to be said that Carmella is probably, and I can't believe I'm saying this, but looking like the strongest member of the group, she seems to be the most unfaltering when it comes to, you know, defending that championship and getting into fights. So you've got to be looking out for her. She's more dangerous than she looks. That running tackle there, dual tackle from the new legacy. Charlotte showing exactly what she thinks of Bayley in that moment as well. No care in the world for Bayley right now with Charlotte. It's surprising to see her competing. She usually doesn't bother, although I guess with the backup of all three other members, she isn't so bothered. She's out here to show that not only is she as good as she says she is, but that she can back up anything when she's got the new legacy around her. Now Bayley has taken it to Charlotte, and now Bayley taking Charlotte into the corner. You can see the tag team work there from Thorne and Bayley. I might be wrong, but I believe this is the first time these two have ever teamed up. And they seem to be holding their own against what is now a very well-established and cohesive unit in the new legacy. But Charlotte there comes right back off, and you can see that cross-body block. But look at Claudia Thorne catches Charlotte, and that rib breaker turns this thing right around in the favor of Thorne and Bayley. This is a 2.5 count from Claudia Thorne there as well. Charlotte only just about got the shoulder up. That was a stunning move. Charlotte tried coming off the top rope, and Claudia was like, nah, biatch. I didn't see that coming. I mean, Thorne is smaller than Charlotte. A great show of strength there from the Dark Angel, but let's try not to get too excited. Let's keep this action focused on the ring. And it was Bayley taking it to Charlotte, but she's incredibly close to the new legacy's corner, and there's the mistake made from Bayley. I don't know what she was doing. Maybe she was just trying to place herself between. Maybe not. Maybe she was trying to go up to the middle rope. And once again, Bayley gets got. She drops down on top of Charlotte there. Admittedly, a little bit of damage done, but not quite in the way she was expecting. That was uncharacteristically stupid of Bayley, quite frankly. I don't mean to put it so harshly, but she just allowed Carmella to take advantage of the situation. We've got a cover here from Claudia Thorne on Charlotte. Charlotte kicks out. Dark Angel going to look to continue on the pressure, dropping the leg across the knee of Charlotte. Probably quite sensible, actually, trying to remove the figure eight from Charlotte's repertoire, but never mind the chop block from the Queen, you know, the Triple S champion, the FABULOUS Yes One. She's in the match, but she's getting beaten up by Claudia Thorne, but Carmella swings out the way, allows Thorne's own momentum to stagger her. Carmella using that strength that we're not really used to seeing from her, but all the same, it worked there, didn't it? Thorn sent to the outside, of course. The high-flying style of Claudia Thorn means that she can hit you from all angles, and Carmella knows it. But Carmella, look at that! She came off the top rope with a body splash. Thorn moves out of the way, and Carmella crashes about 10 feet into the floor. Well, from 10 feet into the floor, you know exactly what I mean. Now Thorn going to try and take advantage of that. Carmella sent into the ring. And there's just a nasty elbow across the face. Now, what's Thorn going to do here? Because, you know, in this kind of prone position, she may attack you. She may try and use one of the more technical moves. She may just fly throughout the ring and just crash on top of you. Instead, she goes to work on that hamstring of Carmella. Mella is trying to fight back. But a jawbreaker from Thorn. And Carmella is in serious trouble now. At least she was for about half a second. Again, you've really got to watch out for Carmella. She is on a roll here as of late. Sends Thorn into the corner where Charlotte was waiting. Charlotte pulls down the rope, and now Claudia Thorn at the call of mercy, the beck and call. I don't know what I'm talking about, but Claudia Thorn trying to fight back against Carmella now, and just sends Carmella crashing into the apron a couple of times over. And Claudia Thorn, we've seen her do things like that in the past, you know. She will just continuously attack someone, use the same move over and over again just to smash their faces in. And Charlotte breaks up that monotony by diving off the apron and taking out Thorn, giving Carmella a chance to catch her breath as well. I'm going to try and take it to Charlotte as well. Absolutely no care in the world as Carmella is held back from the referee. Claudia Thorn delivers an elbow to the face of Charlotte. Look at that. Excuse me. Claudia Thorn came back into the ring, but Carmella just went nuts. And look at Mella now. She's gone under the ring with that sledgehammer. She sees the referee getting up, thinks better of it. But there could have been a moment there while Carmella would have been happy to break the rules behind the referee's back. You can see it there, and that's the mentality of the new legacy. They will do whatever it takes. Look at this fisherman's driver from Claudia Thorn. Carmella in serious trouble. Now Thorn goes up, sets up. She's going to flip through. There it is, sunset flip driver. Now Claudia going to go up top, and you know what she's going to go for here. She's going to turn it around. Moonstomp! And Charlotte there, Tamina, all of them distracting the referee. And look at that, Tamina distracts the ref while Charlotte makes her way into the ring. Meaning Charlotte was more than capable of breaking up the pinfall before it even got started there. And Charlotte just going to add a little bit of insult to injury with that backdrop, that back suplex. Look at Tamina there, she slipped a steel chair in the ring. Using distraction techniques to avoid the referee's wrath, Claudia Thorn staggered from that move, and now Carmella with the Manhattan drop, or possibly the atomic drop. Again, still don't know which one's which. If you do know, please let me know, because I keep getting confused. You should know by now. And again, Tamina looks like she's going to distract the referee, but Claudia Thorn still able to take advantage of a situation there. She needs to get out of that corner, bridging Northern Lights suplex. She doesn't hold the bridge, but she goes for the cover at the first possible opportunity afterwards. Carmella able to kick out of her own volition at two there. The drop kick there, right to the back of the skull. Poignant and deadly as ever. Crowd getting exactly what they want then. They got some Bayley. Carmella not going to allow herself to be suckered into a trap. And look at Carmella there. Let's Bayley chase her out of the ring, which gives her enough time to tag in Charlotte. And now Carmella. Lou Fez press and a couple of big right hands there. Three of them, in fact. Right to the skull of Bayley as Carmella slips out of the ring, allowing Charlotte to take advantage. Charlotte building off of Carmella's groundwork there with the knees to the chest. One to the top of the spine. And another one right across the face. And Charlotte is feeling good, baby. The Flair Strut. That uppercut there from Bailey, though. The Charlotte Spear connects. Bailey is in trouble. She needs to get out of there if she's got any chance of surviving this one. But look at Charlotte placing herself between Bailey and Thorne. And now Charlotte's going to slip behind. Carmella jumps off the apron. Natural selection from Charlotte. And Carmella sweeps out the legs of Claudia. Thorne on the outside. We got a cover now. There's one, two, three. There you have it. Teamwork from the new legacy, effective as ever. It all worked out in the end. It looked troublesome for them at times. You've got to say, Bailey and Thorne, they've never worked together before. They came together tonight with a common goal, and that was upsetting the new legacy, putting them down. But then they fought hard, they fought valiantly. But that move there, I mean, that was just beautiful tag team work from the new legacy. That move there, I mean, I'm still stunned by the fact that Claudia was able to catch Charlotte flying through the air and turn it into that rib breaker. It's not even like she just used the momentum to carry her through to the move either. It was a straight dead stop. You know, you usually see that out of some massive super heavyweights. You see, this is where Bailey was dropped onto Charlotte. Did more damage than I thought because Charlotte didn't get up for a while. I think Claudia sensed it as well, which is why she went straight into the ring, made a beeline for Charlotte's prone body, and went for the cover. She actually moved her out of the way of the ropes, and then went for the cover. It was a smart move, but it just wasn't enough to get the job done. Charlotte certainly not damaged. Maybe she was playing possum. I don't know. Whatever the case, the final few moments of this matchup, Charlotte strikes with natural selection. We can see Carmella here playing the most important role of all, taking out Claudia Thorne, stopping her from running the interference, as inside the ring the referee moves into position and Bailey has nothing left to fight. Here are your winners, the Triple S champion Carmella and the Patriot champion Charlotte, the new legacy. Job done, with Night of Champions looming. All three of their belts will be on the line. You've got to wonder how much power New Legacy is going to come out of that pay-per-view with. They've got it all right now. They're only short of the Women's World Championship. But that could all change very, very soon. We're going to move on to our main event this evening, and the following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from the United Kingdom, the Flame Princess, Jemma Noll. Of course, this match came about after last week's main event was thrown out. Emma and Jemma Noll came to blows on the ramp, quite frankly. Jemma Noll was making her way to the ring. Emma tried to take out some of the frustrations she's been feeling over the past few weeks on her former enemy, on her rival, on Jemma Noll. Ended up getting the entire match thrown out. Stephanie McMahon made the declaration that we're not going to have that. We are going to have this matchup. We are going to have this main event level match. We're going to have it next week with Falls Count Anywhere. No disqualifications, no countouts. We will have a definitive winner. Introducing her opponent from Melbourne, Australia, Emma. These two have had some classic matchups over the past 6-7 months. They first came to blows inside the Elimination Chamber last April. And then they had their first one-on-one encounter at Immortality. Since then, they've had three or four more matches, and each and every one of them has been a complete slobber knocker. Now look at Jaminal straight away. She's gone for the steel chair. She's not going to let Emma jump her today. Well, there you go. Match begins. Sorry about the cough. Jaminal just going for it. Look at her. Just that steel chair crashing over the skull of Emma. Jaminal, usually quite a good-natured woman, all right? She's quite quiet. She keeps herself to herself. Well, look at this. We've got the first cover of the match up already. Emma kicks out with ease, but I think Jaminal has just had enough of just being bullied by these women, especially by Emma. Now, Emma attacked her last week, and Jaminal has not forgotten it. She's up on the apron now. Look at that, off the top rope with that springboard moonsault. And Emma just gets clocked. This is dangerous. We know Emma is the queen of Falls Count anyway. We've seen some of the matches which she's had. We've got a cover here from Jaminal. There's another 1.5 count there. We've seen some of the matches Jaminal has Emma has had with the likes of Jaminal, Falls Count Anywhere in the past. We've seen it. And it was incredible. We've also seen her versus Paige in Falls Count Anywhere matchups. And again, they were just incredible matches. Emma truly is the queen of Falls Count Anywhere, but right now it's Jaminal who's taking it to said queen. And using that exposed TV monitor, and Jesus Christ, right off that TV monitor, Emma's head just smashed in. And if Emma isn't careful, she's not going to be able to walk out of this matchup. She has taken so many strikes to the head with steel, with television monitors, and now Jaminal using his steel chairs as well. This could get very, very dangerous very, very quickly. And look at Jaminal now, again, strikes the skull. Again, usually a very good-natured woman, but I think she has just had enough lately. But Jaminal got a little too confident there for a second. You see Emma hopping over the barricade there. Jaminal going to follow her, or is she going to be led into that trap? Looks like she is, but Emma, you know she's going to be waiting for it. Nope, Jaminal strikes out instead. Now Emma that is able to fight back, and look at that knee sends Jaminal crashing back over the barricade. We've got to think, we haven't really speculated much, but with the recent change in attitude of the former Women's World Champion legend Jezzy, that may have affected Jaminal as well. They're the best friends, you know, we know that about the two of them, which is what made their match at the Royal Rumble last year so special. There is every chance in the world that that is in the back of her mind while she's trying to compete in this matchup. But look at Emma there, using the steel to her advantage. The back kick there from Jaminal, though, this is brutal. We don't even see this kind of brutality out of most of the men, never mind the women. Jaminal with the, is that a baseball bat? Yeah, it is a baseball bat. Just going completely bananas there. You see, she's not attacking Emma, she's just attacking anything that's there, inanimate or otherwise. She goes in for another steel chair, but Emma was waiting for it this time, and this could be bad news for the Jaminal there. Oh no, I thought Emma was going to drive her into the chair, but no, she just throws her halfway across the arena. Referee, you think, would be closer to the action, but there you go, there's the cover, there's one, there's two. Jaminal able to roll the shoulder up. Emma not happy about it, and you can understand why. He was waiting inside the ring. What's he doing there? Should be following this action around ringside. Now Emma with a suplex on the outside. This is Falls Count Anywhere, and I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure we haven't even seen them go into the ring in this matchup yet, so living up to the moniker, I guess. Looks like a car wreck round ringside right now. Jaminal, Tigress Bomb on the outside. What's she waiting for? She's not going for the cover, and that is very telling. from the Jaminal. Straight right forearms there. And look at that step up into Guri. Emina steps out of the way though. Turns it around. Face buster bulldog. Obviously. You know what I mean. Jaminal right back in this thing though. But look at Emma with that Luthes press. These two just going at it. There is nothing between them. Nothing. I mean, I guess you've got to give the edge to Emma considering that she's been battered around the skull about 8 times with various objects, including a human body. But right now, this thing is going bananas. And Jaminal, what's she doing here? She's... no spear! Look at that! Emma just speared right through the barricade. Look at this ringside area. There's hats and monitors and chairs and stairs and everything else. The Jaminal drops into the cover. We got one. We got two. We got three. My God, what a match. And that wasn't even a match, it was a fight. Look at this, this is very early on in the matchup. Emma didn't even have time to get into the ring because Jaminal just started wailing on her with that steel chair. Cracked her across the skull about 3 times. Look at this there. That's what I meant by a human body connecting with a skull. Jaminal landed on the head of Emma. Doesn't matter where, how light or heavy or whatever she is, she came off that top rope with all the momentum in the world with that springboard and crashed onto the skull of Emma. But to Emma's credit, look at that move there. She fought back. That double underhook suplex threw Jaminal about 4 feet away. And that could have been the end of the matchup if the referee had been in position. Let's not forget that. It took the ref so long to get into position. Tigress bomb, that was the beginning of the end for Emma. And there it is, that barricade just exploded as those two women cracked into it. Jaminal did some damage to herself there, you can't argue with that. But look at this, she just sees Emma trying to get back to her feet. A straight kick to the stomach there, knocked Emma back down. An opportunity knocks. Jaminal falls into the cover and the referee, and well, maybe annoyingly for Emma, was in position this time. And a straight 3 count puts Jaminal on top. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, the Jaminal. And look, she's in the ring for the first time in this matchup. It's the first time either woman enters the ring is post-match. Hang on a minute. Huge announcement from Stephanie McMahon there. I said the Patriot title situation was getting complicated. Well, she's just uncomplicated it. Charlotte will defend in a fatal 4-way at Night of Champions. Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name has been the Ripper Danny B, and that was CWR Asylum. No, it wasn't. It was Horizon. My God, I'm on the wrong chain of thought here. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you tomorrow. Take care, and remember to keep it safe.